What's up, everyone? I'm Matt, and I'm back with another Maya Quick Tip. So have you ever been working on a scene when you notice that suddenly things are moving way slower than they did before? Maybe you're modeling and every time you add an edge, Maya lags for just a second or two. Or maybe you're animating and getting single-digit FPS. Sometimes you might know exactly what operation you did that caused this slowdown, but oftentimes you might not have a clue. Well, what if I told you that Maya has a tool specifically designed to help you find these bottlenecks in your scene? It's called the Profiler. Let me show you how it works by comparing two scenes. Here, we have a simple facial animation running at a smooth 24 FPS. And here, we have a nearly identical facial animation running at less than 1 FPS. So what gives? To find out, let's go to my slow scene and open the Profiler. This is a tool that records all the background processes going on within a given amount of time, then shows you how long each one takes. To use it, simply start recording by pressing the record button up here, then do whatever it is that has poor performance in your scene. In this case, I can simply advance the time slider. Then stop it. Now you can see the profiler is full of colored bars, some of which are very long and some of which are so short that they're barely visible. Each of these bars represents a process, and as you've probably already figured out, the longer the bar means the longer that process is taking to finish. So let's take a closer look at some of the longer ones. To navigate the profiler, I can use the same hotkeys as the viewport. Usually, I like to start in the main section to get a high-level view of what's going on. If I zoom in here, you'll see two bars that are very long. Let's select one and use the F key to frame it. Below in the info bar, you can see that this green line belongs to set current time. This is the process Maya uses to set the current frame number. As you can see, it's currently ticking 2 seconds from start to finish, which is a long time for a single frame. Ideally, it should be 1/24th of a second. However, set current time is almost never the cause of a slowdown. Usually it's just a symptom of something else bogging down the scene. So then that begs the question, which of these bars are symptoms and which ones are possible causes of our bottleneck? To figure that out, I'm going to select the entire frame, right-click, then select Show Critical Path. This is a special tool that highlights the sequence of tasks that represent the minimum evaluation time for that frame. In other words, even in a world where your computer had infinite resources, the scene would not be able to evaluate faster than whatever's highlighted. I'm not too worried about this small highlighted bar, but this long one belonging to PolyRetopo 1 appears to be the problem. This actually jogs my memory about what I did to the scene. I did an animation first, but then retopologized the head to reduce the overall number of faces. So each time the face deforms, that retopologization has to be calculated all over again. Compare that to this other scene where I retopologized first before animating. This performs that complex calculation before the deformation, so at animation time, it becomes a non-issue. And without that extra overhead, the next slowest thread is only about 6 milliseconds long, nearly 250 times faster. You can also use the profiler to search for specific processes. This is handy if you already suspect there's a slowdown somewhere, or if you just want to check how long a certain process takes. You can also display processes in a number of different ways, including by CPU core and by threads. And that's the profiler in a nutshell. In general, I think you'll find most of your slowdowns come from either this evaluation section for deformers and effects, or the VP evaluation section for viewport rendering. Maybe the BIF section if you're using Bifrost. Of course, this is a tool for diagnosing problems. Once you actually find them, you'll need to figure out how to fix them. For some more help on that, I'll drop a link in the description below to some general advice, as well as some common bottleneck examples. And if you find this advice helpful, be sure to leave a like, share, and subscribe, and tune in for my next video. See you later!